Happy New Year and welcome to Sherwood New Life. We are so glad that you are here and welcome to 2023. Boy, does that sound weird. And you know what? The weird thing is that it's actually 2022 when I'm saying that, so it's even weirder, but that's okay. So we are glad that you have joined us on this New Year's Day. And we are just going to spend a few brief moments together here. And I just want to give you just a few tidbits to make you think and jump into this new year of 2023. Let's pray first, though. Lord, I thank you for this new year, and I pray that you would bless it, Lord. And I pray that we would go into it intentionally, following you and doing your will this year. And I just pray that you will speak to us in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. I love a new year. It's always kind of done something for me. You have a fresh new start. You have a fresh new year. You can set up fresh new systems for everything. And it's just... it's just a time of renewal and moving forward. And the thing about a new year is that we can kind of re-gear, re-shift, and reset. And one of the things as Christians, we need to be very intentional in the way we live our lives. Everyone likes to come up with New Year's resolutions, which they immediately break, which usually have something to do with a gym or exercise, and it lasts until probably January 3rd. And, you know, those things, setting goals that are way too big, and, you know, everybody online who is an influencer makes money because they sell goal-setting packages, and it goes on and on and on. So anyway, what I suggest instead is that you set up your life, however that is. Some people are paper pen people. Some people are, use their phones. However you organize your life and make sure that you, you know, have all of the things that you need to have done, and reminders and task lists and all of that, I would suggest to you that you make sure that you are being very intentional. So what does that mean as a Christian? It means that you are very intentional in following the Lord. You are intentional in having a prayer life. You're intentional in spending time in the Word, whether it's devotional reading or an in-depth Bible study. Whatever it may be, you're being very intentional in doing that. Because when you do that, that opens up your heart to the Holy Spirit. And if you are open to the Holy Spirit, He will guide you in the things that He wants you to do. It might be things that He wants you to accomplish, or people He wants you to talk to, or whatever it might be. You are open to that, and you are being very intentional, because we are, as humans, we are, it is very easy for us to just let life slide on by, and all of a sudden, it's December again, and you've wasted a whole year doing pretty much nothing. And so we have to be intentional in how we live our life and that lifestyle that we have. And there is a verse, and it's Luke 14:28. And in the ESV, it says, "For which of you, desiring to build a tower, does not first sit down and count the cost, whether he has enough to complete it?" Now, Jesus is talking about the cost of discipleship here. And really, the way you live your life is part of discipleship, because discipleship means that you are growing. And if you're not intentional about the way you are living your life, then you're not growing and you're not a very good disciple. And so I want to just urge you to think about that as we head into this new year, 2023, and be intentional on how you live your life. Now, if you are interested in how do you do that, how do you set that up? Well, just, you know what, follow us here at the church on Sunday mornings, and I'm going to be intentional this year teaching those things. We are going to be covering a lot of that this year at the church. So just like they say on TV, stay tuned. But I would just this week, right now, today, start out 2023 with say 5 minutes in prayer and maybe 5 minutes in the Word. That's better than nothing. And you're being intentional, and open up your heart to the Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Lord, I thank you for this new year. I thank you that we can live our lives intentional on following you. And Lord, I pray for those who really want to make this commitment of living intentionally. Lord, I pray that you would help them, and that we at the church would be able to give them resources. I pray that if people need help personally, that they would contact us, and know that that is okay. We would love to do that. We would love to help people. But Lord, we intentionally follow you. We make that commitment to follow you this year in 2023 more than we ever have before, Lord. And we thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, again, Happy New Year. And we will see you back here. We will meet in person again next Sunday. And again, we will be online also, but just wanted to let you know we will be meeting in both. And also keep watch on our Facebook website, because we are doing a week of prayer this week. And each day you will see the topic that we are praying about, and you can join us as we pray together this week. Have a great week, and again, Happy New Year.